Okay, so here we have our meatballs and our little Smokies. You're going to add your barbecue sauce. Now this is a 40-ounce bottle. We don't really need all of that, because as it cooks, it's going to cook down. What I normally do, and probably what I should have done this time, is actually cook this a little and let some of that grease release from the meat and strain it. But, oh well, too late now. Hold a second. Okay, so here we have about, I put about 2 tablespoons of jelly. Now what you want to do, when it start cooking, you can taste it and see what consistency you like. I don't really stir mine up and mix up. I just let it cook through. As it cooks through, you know, you'll see it'll form. And this, usually, like I said, usually goes in the crock pot. But today I'm doing it in the pot because I'm making my roti dip in my crock pot. And I'm going to actually get on while I'm at church also. So here you have your, this is all you need to do. Now when you come back, if you come back and look and everything is combined, well, when it's actually liquefied, the jelly have, you're going to have to come in and stir it thin. And then you may want to add a little more barbecue sauce, or you may want to add a little more jelly to your taste, you know, to your preference. But this is all you do for your meatballs. Now some people cut up pineapple and all that. I just like it simple, just like this. And you know, there's also a recipe with the Smokies where you do the barbecue sauce, and then you put you slice fresh lemon and fresh orange and put it in, and it gives it like a little tangy barbecue flavor, because it cooks, that citrus flavor cooks down in it. So I'll give you one of those videos one day. But for time saving purposes, and also just to not have a whole bunch of dishes, honestly, when we were finished, I combined these two, and it's just as good this way. The flavors actually, what they say, marry one another, and it's actually good. So I'll come back and show you the finished product.